G'day! It's that time of year again, Doscember, where YouTubers like myself look at all things for DOS. Today I thought I'd look at a particular flavour of DOS. FreeDOS, that came on CDs on relatively modern computers. In fact, I know that Dell has been shipping FreeDOS with modern computers for quite some time. Since about 2002, something like that. Maybe a little bit earlier. But anyhow, basically when you buy a new Dell computer, if you select no operating system, a CD much like this is what you'll get. This one is from August 2002, and so that's what we'll take a look at today.
FreeDOS was started by Jim Hall when Microsoft announced that they were dropping MS-DOS sales and support at the end of June 1994. I decided to install it in an instance of 86-box, set up to be a 100 MHz Pentium system, with a CD drive, so I could install everything from the one disk. The install process wasn't too painful and is kind of similar to the more familiar MS-DOS. I basically just had to partition the hard drive with FDisk, then reboot and run the installation program. Because this is a much earlier version of FreeDOS, there isn't quite as much to explore compared to the current release, but all the basics are there. There are drivers for extended and expanded memory, CD-ROM drives, and mice. The command line utilities are present, but tools like DOS Shell and Defrag aren't available in this version. I loaded up some classic DOS games to see if they would work. The only one which didn't work was Commander Keen 4, which wouldn't load because there wasn't enough conventional RAM. Otherwise all the classic games I tried worked quite well. I tinkered with the setup of FDXMS and loading DOS High, but I couldn't increase the amount of conventional memory available. I later found this desktop environment called Seal. There wasn't all that much to explore other than settings and a few simple games. I felt like it was still under development and that I would need to run it on a faster virtual machine to get a better experience. Whilst the old beta version of FreeDOS is probably sufficient for running most DOS programs, you do end up with less conventional RAM than you might need. This tends to be a problem with games that came out before DOS extenders became commonly used. Commander Keen is an example of a game that doesn't run on the beta easily. So to be fair to FreeDOS, let's take a look at a more recent release. The install process was fairly easy on a clean hard disk image. Again, just use FDisk to create a partition, then reboot and run the installer. At first I chose to install all the applications and games, which requires about 250 megabytes. Alternatively, you can install only the base system to save space. After playing with it for a while, I recommend you go with just the base install, then use the package manager to add software from the install media as required. With a full install, I ended up with an overwhelming number of programs, with many having duplicate functionality. It doesn't make much sense to have them all installed. Fortunately, the package manager is pretty easy to use, so removing or installing packages is relatively easy. The base install has the usual DOS command line programs. Memory managers and drivers are installed and configured by default, and on boot you get a menu to choose how you want the system configured. Out of the box I had 624k of conventional memory available with XMS, EMS, a mouse driver, and CD-ROM driver, which is better than you can achieve with MS-DOS. Consequently, old games that require large amounts of conventional memory should run without it having to make a boot disk. Speaking of old games, I tried the same games again. This time Commander Keen worked quite well. There were some games included on the FreeDOS install disk. Some of these were interesting, but I haven't spent much time with them yet. The CD has quite a few other utilities and editors, so it's well worth looking through the package list and trying a few. I found two nifty programs I think are quite useful. The first is DOS Navigator, which seems to be like Norton Commander from back in the day. I really liked how usable this program is. For file management and navigation, it's an excellent option. The second program is called PGME, which is a menu program. For starting applications, this seems to be a good option, although I have had a little fun setting up my own menu options. I tried to set up Commander Keen. I eventually got it to run, but the menu didn't return after terminating the game. I suspect this is because of how the menu program works. It will require a bit of tinkering to get running. Together, these two programs are a decent replacement for something like the DOS shell. There are some other options on the install CD as well, such as a DOS shell clone, but I haven't really tried them out yet. So how does FreeDOS compare to running good old MS-DOS? It has quite a few advantages, such as having more conventional memory available out of the box. It supports larger hard disk drives and partitions, with the option of long file name support and FAT32. I saw that there was some basic USB support, and there are networking tools such as MTCP included. These advantages make the most sense with a more modern DOS computer, as older machines simply don't require many of these things. You can technically run FreeDOS on most 8086 computers, but there are far fewer advantages over MS-DOS there. I think one of the main ones is tab completion in the default command processor. MS-DOS has some advantages over FreeDOS as well. It has support for Windows 386 enhanced mode, and the network tools for file sharing over TCP or IPX are different. There are small tools such as Interlink which aren't available in FreeDOS, although there are other solutions for file transfer. The final advantage MS-DOS has is US. Basically, older users like myself have nostalgic feelings when using it, especially old tools like DOS Shell, which have decent replacements in FreeDOS but feel different to use. Whichever one you choose, the FreeDOS project is a valuable contribution to the open source and retro computing community. Many useful tools have been made specifically for FreeDOS that are helpful on any DOS computer. Qt Mouse coming to mind first, but also many others. That's all I have for today. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you next time.